All right, next in this series, we're getting out of the trees and we are getting where? We are getting into savanna lands. I have to speak really fast, my computer's dying out. Okay, we're getting into savanna lands. Now, we are switching now our diet. We're switching it majorly from fruits, and we're bringing in vegetables. We're bringing in tubers, all kinds of things that we can keep longer. When we're out there on the savanna, we can take them with us and hold them many months. So it's a real changeover. And during this time frame, we are losing our hair, we're losing our fur, we're becoming more this naked skin rather than our furry beast cousins of the ape. So in this moment also, we are at the, what are those creatures? You can look at the Maasai, and yes, they do tap into the side of a cow and they drink the blood, the yak, the wild thing there. And so that was starting to go on, very possibly because they were not getting enough stores in their reserves, in their system, based upon the tuber. A really starch-heavy diet, because it was a very starch-heavy beginning with so many vegetables that way. So here we are now, and it's not all running around saying leafy greens, because that would have been that's seasonal, but the tubers would have been something that would have been really held over through winter. When we're also thinking about, and then we had this aggressive group kick us out from the trees, from that nirvana moment of our evolution. We were kicked out. The evolution never stops, remember. You know, the person next to you is also an evolution moment. So they could be that same type of self. Kicker outer type, that's all that they live for. So we're out there, and we really have changed our diet. We start to now clumb more and more to this big yak cow thing. And you know, if even probably the remains of what's out there in that savanna, which would be lots of you know, just like vultures, we would have lived like vultures after the carcasses until we really did learn how to kill. We would have been just like the vultures, doing a similar, going, you know, well, this is really rancid, that we're not going to eat it, it has to be there fresh. And so we would be fighting over that dead animal. And then eventually go, well, if we kill it, we have to fight, we can fight less, we don't have to fight the hyenas, we don't have to fight the lions, we don't have to fight that saber tooth if we kill it first. So all of this would start being connected in our hunter brain, because we didn't have to do any of this before. We're just in the tree, you know, we're just in those trees. So here we're now in looking at the moment of, we are getting very, very oriented and self aware that this is bringing the food. You know, no longer are we looking at the trees that were easy. So it must have been a terrible turn away that we didn't want to go back, that we would prefer all of the work effort involved in fighting over carcass, making that carcass ourselves happen. That would have been extremely wow, you know, like a wow have to. So here we are with the keeping of the meat, and now we know we're back to, well, it was killed. And so if they killed it, and then so things start to happen, you know, they start to parade around with it, and they start to bring it into cultural events, and so the meat here you have the cow, the pig, whatever they kill, the wild boar, that becomes a cultural event, you know, becomes the big man, you know, who did it. So it becomes an ego trip from that hunter. Where before, the hunted ego, the hunter's ego, didn't exist to that greatness. So we are now developing a hunter's ego. Big man kill, you know, big man who has killed, you know. So he's strutting around that he was the winner of the game. He was the winner. And he gets celebrated because the people are hungry. And so he's celebrated by what he has done. So this is how our current human has been founded, is off that celebration. Rather than that man, we'll say, that man or that group of men, hey, saying, hey, let's go back to those trees and let's get a beautiful cornucopia of fruits and vegetables available. And let's just eat those. You know, that man can do that same action and be a hero and be celebrated. So I guess that's where I'm headed today. It's just that discussion. Oh, and our teeth. Remember, as evolution states, as all of the cute little, skeleton heads they have out there, beautiful, beautiful teeth. Those beautiful teeth are the frugivores. The omnivores start to have caries. So all of that starts to happen when we bring in big bunches of grains and the meats. We start to get a lot of diseased teeth.